Going back up to my retreat at Crawford's Burn near Belfast. This was the reason that I went to Ireland. I also traveled around afterwards, but this is why I went. And Peter Rollins is a philosopher, and he was the one who put on the retreat. He brought in artists, authors, creative people came from all over the world. This is one of the entertainers that he had come. She was so funny. Oh my gosh. This was a singer, Ben Glover from Nashville. And Barry was one of the speakers. There's Peter Rollins. And artist Johnny, who was doing paintings. Every day he would add to the painting, and it was great. At the end, he gave us each a piece of it. We had gin tasting, a magician. I'll leave a link for this magician's Facebook page with his videos. He's a really incredible magician. So the retreat was really relaxing. There was a lot of fun. We went on tours together. This was our photographer. I decided to take some pretty pictures of her, Catherine. A comedian. Yeah, was he? Peter Rollins hired this comedian. He was so funny, and just, oh my gosh, we had us laughing so hard. At the very end, they put out a suitcase, and we put in the suitcase things we're going to leave behind and what we're going to take. And this was the painting. We each got a little piece of it. I guess, why did I go to this? Was because just wanted to reawaken my creative side and be together with other creative people. The next pictures you're going to see are our tour that we went on. Adam led this tour. He arranges for around Belfast for painters, artists who will paint these gorgeous paintings on side of buildings, in over the rubble, on the sides of buildings where not too long ago there was a lot of violence and a lot of trauma happened, and now there's just beauty, and what they call it is transformance art. And so pretty much the idea is that I understood was that creative work and art can transform violence and hatred and trauma into something new. You can never get rid of the trauma. It's always there, but there's an opportunity with creativity and art to transform it into something new, to take it, to own it, and to move with it and help it and have it help you move through the pain. Those things aren't going to go away, and we shouldn't forget we do have to figure out how to move on. So why did I go to this retreat? To awaken my creative side. And one of the things that I learned was, oh, this is Voices from the Grave. Okay, so that little clip right there, if you look up on YouTube, you'll understand a little bit more about what happened with the Troubles in Ireland. Very interesting video. The voices of the two leaders of the two different sides are speaking. They're both passed away now, and just very interesting. But one of the things that I learned in the retreat was to embrace the muck. to embrace my voice, to embrace my own creativity, and to use my creative side to transform myself and to maybe help transform the world. Because there's trauma and there's pain everywhere. All of us have it. If you're born, if you're a human, you have trauma and pain. I loved Ireland. I just felt like there was just this kind of undergirding of this kind of little rebel art philosophy. It was just everywhere. It was all over the walls, everywhere, all over Ireland, all over, you know, even in the Wi-Fi passwords, or there's art and transformance. Now, you know, I don't live there. I don't know what the internal feeling is, but what I felt by just my short visit was that there's something really good happening there. A famous poet who was supposed to be at a retreat but wasn't able to come, he was involved in peace processes in other parts of the world, and what he had done and other people had done is helped to create spaces where people could be heard, where people's different viewpoints can be heard, and people with totally polar opposite viewpoints and opposite beliefs or different beliefs and thoughts and processes can safely hear each other, and you don't have to walk away believing what the other person believes, but you've heard them and you've been heard. That's what I understand is one of the things that helped transformed Ireland's trauma. These are friends from my retreat. Friends from my trips. So really we walked away knowing that we were all well, I just like the quote, you know, I'm not okay, you're not okay, that's not okay, but that's okay. All right, Merry Christmas, and oh my gosh, I gotta leave you in Galway, Ireland.
Oh my goodness, I'm here in Galway, Ireland. And Santa Claus is coming in a few minutes. The town is a bustle. There's a Ferris wheel, lights. There's gonna be a band, apparently.
Santa Claus on here. Coming up to the Spanish Arch about 6:25. Down at
Gorham. It's a Christmas market.
D Street at 6:35. Going up to Hartman at about 7:10. Coming on then to 1K at 7:13.
Ooh, check out these balloons. Oh, those are so awesome. Oh my gosh.
Turn on the lights.
I walked away from the retreat, somehow in pieces and somehow together. We realized that we were all there gathered, not with the same beliefs or with any amount of certainty about anything, but that we were all committed to uncertainty, and we left in pieces and unknowing, but it's okay. This experience in Galway after my retreat was will go down in my life as one of the best experiences of my life. I really experienced their goodwill toward men, standing in the crowds of people from all over the world. Traveling alone, I didn't feel alone, and I hope that you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching, and Merry Christmas. Oh my gosh, he followed me home.